students, before starting the next part of the chapter, that is halogens, let me remind you that the remaining chemical reactions of haloalkanes and one important example of haloalkane, which is chloroform. Preparation, application, please study from my notes. So today we start with halogens and we define halogens first. What is the meaning of halogens? So when halogen atoms are attached to benzene ring, then the compounds are called as halogens. Very simple. When the halogen atoms are attached directly to the benzene ring. Okay, this is the halogen atom attached to benzene ring. So this is an example of halogen. And the name of this compound is IUPAC nomenclature also, how to give IUPAC name to halogens. The first example here, as you can see, this one. Now we have to give IUPAC name to this compound. So there are more than one halogen atom on this benzene ring. So how to give the numbering to these carbon atoms? So you select any one halogen atom and the numbering to the next carbon atom has to be done in such a way that it should get the lowest number. So if we start from here, so this will be the second carbon atom having substituent chlorine. Because if you move from this side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, this carbon atom will get number 6, which is wrong. So this is the proper numbering and the name of this compound is 1,2-dichlorobenzene. Okay, so the name of this compound is 1,2-dichlorobenzene. Now next example here. Okay, let us understand this example first. If you start with this bromine atom, this carbon atom is 1, then 2 and this is 3. Because if you do numbering anti-clockwise, so these carbon atoms will get higher number, which is wrong. So this is the proper numbering and now the name. Tribromobenzene. Now look at this example. If you start from this carbon atom here, 1, 2, 3, 4. This bromine atom gets second number, this one gets fourth number. And if you start numbering from this side, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, the third bromine atom gets sixth number, which is wrong. Okay. So numbering has to be again clockwise. So this will be 1,2,4 tribromobenzene. Now some important example. As you can see here, The two substituents which are present on the benzene ring are different. One is methyl group and the second substituent is chlorine atoms. In this case, methyl group gets the priority. That's why this carbon atom you have to give number 1. Automatically, remaining concept you know now. This will be the sequence of numbering for the remaining carbon atoms containing chlorine atoms. So now you know the name. You forget about these two chlorine atoms. This compound is called toluene. This is called toluene. Toluene. CH3 group attached to benzene. And now first you give the name to the substituent. So this will be 2,4. 2,4. Dichloro. What is this compound? Toluene. Okay, so many more examples are there in the text and in my notes also. Practice well the nomenclature. As you know that in board examination, compulsorily one question is asked based on nomenclature. Okay, not only starting with the preparation method, only one preparation method today. Preparation of halogens. So very simple method we have to start. You take a benzene ring. Okay, you take benzene liquid and treat with chlorine gas. But conditions are important. Catalyst is Fe. Fe means iron. And reaction is carried out in dark condition. Dark condition. So you get your halogen, and in this case the halogen is chlorobenzene. Now in the same method, which is called halogenation, because you are adding halogen, it is called halogenation. So same method, if you take excess. ज़्यादा अगर क्लोरीन लेंगे सो यू विल गेट मिक्सचर मिक्सचर ऑफ प्रोडक्ट 1,2 डाइक्लोरोबेंजीन एंड 1,4 डाइक्लोरोबेंजीन. सो दिस आल्सो ऑलरेडी वी हैव इन आवर नोट्स. सो प्लीज गो थ्रू दिस कॉन्सेप्ट. There go, practice some more examples for IUPAC nomenclature. After that we'll continue with more methods of preparation of halogens. Very important methods of preparation of halogens are there, and board examination point of view they are very important, because they are all mostly name reactions. They are name reactions, that's why they are more important. Okay students, so we'll continue next time. Have a nice day. Thanks.